Family Viewing TV. We are jumping in the next video for the machine here, the Can-Am Maverick X3 Turbo. We've done a lot of videos over the past few years, I'd say a couple years actually, doing different installs from the tire to the roof racks, the whip lights, doors, windshields, chase lights. There's just a whole abundance of radio. So if you're interested in those and you haven't done those and that's what you're looking for, you can go back to the channel and check those videos out. I'll leave some links in the description. But today we are coming to our first issue with the machine. We haven't had no issues with this machine as of yet, and we haven't done any fixes on this machine. So today we're going to attempt to do our first fix video. And you're probably wondering what I'm talking about with this machine and what's going on. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what is going on. I've got a fault code popping up on the front of the cluster. I went to turn on the machine the other day to take my family out for a ride, and it wouldn't start. And it was telling me that I needed to push the override button. Let me show you guys a quick look at what I'm talking about so we can try to get down to the bottom of this. Okay, folks, what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to attempt to turn this machine on and see what it shows. PPS fault. Press override. So, this is why my machine won't start, and I couldn't figure it out. I've been trying to. And nothing seems to be working, so we are going to attempt to render this ourselves and then see what we can find out. I'm pushing other buttons like my menu button, trip button, not doing anything. It's basically just stuck on that mode right there, PPS fault. I was hoping to get into some settings here. I don't know if that fault will just stay like that, flashing that for quite a bit of time. But yeah, trying to start it, that's all it does. It just kind of flashes and then goes to PPS fault. I wanted to go into our settings here to try to look at some different things that it could be showing on the cluster, but it's not. So I'm going to do some research further into this PPS fault code, and we are going to work with this together and see if we can figure it out ourselves. That way, if you guys end up running into this same problem later on down the road, then at least you can try to attempt to fix this yourself. I'm going to go ahead and wager to say that this fault is going to have something to do with the power system. And when I say power system, I mean the battery. So I'm going to do, like I said, a little bit more research, and then we're going to jump right back into this and see if we can figure out why we are getting this fault code and what does this typically stem from in some instances. Sometimes, you know, it could be something as simple as the battery, and sometimes it could be the actual PPS issue. So we'll figure out what PPS actually stands for, and then we'll jump right back into this and see what we can find out. Okay guys, so pedal positioning sensor is what PPS stands for. So I don't think it's the pedal. My machine only has like just about 500 miles on it there. Doesn't mean that it can't be the pedal positioning sensor, but I'm going to wager to say it's going to be something more of the battery. When I was checking out the voltage on the battery on the dash cluster there, it was saying it was like an 8.1, which is pretty low. I would assume the battery should be up at the 11 to 12 range. So that's going to be my first suspicion. I have this power management system I had installed by Side-by-Side Labs here, as you guys can see right there, a while back. And they put in everything real nice, got a nice fuse board for all my accessories. And I actually have two batteries in this system, if you look. It's hard to tell, but there's a battery that goes right here, and then there's another battery right here next to it. Generally, this battery right here that's closest to your console is going to be your start battery, and then the second battery is going to be your accessories battery. So if any batteries are going to be having any problem, it's probably going to be this first battery right here on the right, my start battery. I did check the leads on here, see if I was getting any loose connections. You can see pretty close that the connections are pretty clean. There's no calcium or any type of battery acid buildup on them. So I'm not going to sit here and think to myself that it's possibly just a loose cable, because it doesn't appear to be. What I am going to do, and I'm going to do this off camera because a lot of you probably don't have this power management system inside of your machine, so it'll be a little bit different to take your battery out. And if you're working with a single battery, well then you'll be able to figure out on your machine how you'll get your battery out. So what I'm going to do is we're gonna try to make this a quick fix video. Is I'm gonna get this battery out, I'm gonna test it, double make sure on what the volts are on it, and if it's really low, I'm probably gonna go ahead and just swap it out, get another one and put it in, and then we'll go from there. So we'll go ahead, get this out, get another battery, test it at the same time just to see if it was a dead battery, and then we'll come back to you guys and go from there. Okay folks, so it's definitely not an easy task. Had to take this seat out, which you can see is taken out over here. There's a significant amount of things you have to take off to get this battery case loose so you can actually get the batteries out. I mean, I have a strap that goes over here, and that straps the batteries in. Then you have this cover that goes in, and then there's several screws that go to this cover and the strap that goes through the wall, your firewall here, to hold those in place. And then you've got a few other screws for the batteries, and there's just tons of wiring. So for me, this is not an easy task. This isn't going to be like a quick 15-minute swap your battery out and put it back in task. But the good thing is I got it loose. As you can see, the battery slides right out now, and we are dealing with, not sure what these batteries are, but that's the battery. Anyways, it's a 12 volt for sure, 18.9 ohms, 270 cranking amps it looks like. So I'm going to have to go find a battery that's similar to this. I'm going to go ahead and probably just get both of them, because I really don't want to have this one installed and then all of a sudden this one goes dead. You know, later on, a month or so later, and then have to do what I did to get all this out. So we're gonna go ahead and get these batteries replaced, and we'll come back and put them back in, and then we'll check to see if we're gonna get that same PPS code fault when we go to start the machine up. And if with any luck that's all it is, then this machine will fire right up and you guys will have an inclination of what to look for if you run into that same issue. Okay guys, so I went down to AutoZone and picked up a couple new Duralast gold batteries. These are AGM batteries. You can see it's a AZX20L. They used to use a different model than that, but they have since then replaced them with this particular model for the Duralast gold brand. They're around 120. They used to be about $160, so they've gotten a little bit cheaper. I'd recommend these AGM batteries if you're using a dual or a single-handed system. So one thing to keep in mind, folks, is, you know, just because you throw in two new batteries and it starts up doesn't 100% eliminate any other potential issues with your charging system. You may have a alternator issue too. So I would keep tabs and I wouldn't go too far unless you make sure that your charging system is working good after. Because you may start the machine, it'll start right up because the batteries are brand new, but then they may not continue to charge because of your charging system, which could potentially leave you stranded. So if you are putting new batteries in, you know, drive around close, check your battery voltage, see if it's staying charged, just to eliminate your charging system. I'm gonna go ahead and hook up all these wires. As you can see, there's all kinds of different wires, and I've got a case there, and then there's a strap that we put over the top of there. So I got quite a few things I gotta put back in place. Then we'll start it up and see what it does. All right, guys, so we got the batteries in. Went ahead and put them on, got all the wiring hooked back up the way it was the first time, all the leads on the positive and negatives. So we are going to try this and see what we get. The moment of impact, folks. Let's go over here. Like I said, guys, just keep in mind, you know, there's always a chance you could have a charging system issue on your machine, whether it's a newer machine or an older machine. Sometimes it just happens. You know, you'd like to think it's just going to be batteries and that's all it's going to happen, but sometimes it is what it is. So let's see if this machine will start. Oh yeah. So everything's hooked back up. Let's go to our menu. Battery volt is at 14.2, so looks like we're good to go for now. Like I said, you never know what's going to happen later, but go ahead and turn it off for now. But it's better that you do you check everything. See how the voltage dropped on the battery? Because, you know, the alternator's not currently shooting power into it. So I'm hoping the charging system is suitable. You know, we'll know later on, I guess. But that's a good sign, because definitely wasn't getting out before. So just wanted to make this quick video for you guys. Like I said, if you go to start up your machine, you get that PPS fault saying to hit the override, don't panic. Don't start thinking it's your pedal down there and you need to replace your pedal, because I've seen some people on feedback that did that and still had the problem. So chances are it was their battery. So if you get a chance, check your battery out. Start with the smaller issues first, the more inexpensive things. And then you shouldn't have such an issue with it. Well, anyways, guys, so review a TV. Appreciate you guys watching the videos. If you haven't seen some of the new videos, I got this machine back here. We got a new Kubota tractor that we've been doing some cool videos on too. So if you're looking into getting a tractor, that may be something to consider watching. There'll be future uploads on that, including the machine here. Just wanted to do this quick video today to help you guys figure something out with the machine if you end up with an issue like this or some faults with that PPS and the batteries. So keep in mind, we'll be doing some future videos real soon here. Look for those up on our channel. If you're not subscribed, subscribe. Hit the all notifications so you don't miss that notification when I do upload. And until next time, we will see you guys then.